Hi friends, this is Sarvajan here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today I'm going to show how to configure the global unicast address. So the global address is a routable address and it is assigned globally. So that is the reason we call this a global unicast address. And this start with 2001:64. That is the reason we call this a global unicast address. So the only difference between link local and the global address, link local is assigned link local, which is not routable, but global address assigned globally and it is routed through the internet. That is the reason we call this as a routable address. So now let us go to the configuration. So before that, let us do a debug IPv6 ND. So that is nothing but I have enabled the debugging for the neighbor discovery protocol. So after that, let us enable first the link local address, right? So how to do that? Go to interface serial 0x0 IPv6 enable. So after enabling this, it will generate the link local address. So this, see, you are able to see, right? It is generating the link local. It is always start with FE80, that's /10. So this is a link local address. So let us check it. Show IPv6 interface, then the serial interface. So you are able to see, right? Your IPv6 enabled and it is generating the link local address. There is no global address configured. So this is nothing but the global unicast address, which is a routable address. So how to configure this? Go to the configuration mode, interface, serial. Before that, what you have to do, I have to enable the unicast routing, IPv6 unicast routing. So I'm going to configure the global address, which is a routable address, right? So go to the configuration mode, interface, serial 0x0, IPv6 address 2001, any address you can assign, :/64, EY-64. So that means it will start generating using the EY64. I already discussed in this previous video. EUI is nothing but a extended unique identifier, right? That will be generated from the interface ID. So you can see here, show IPv6 interface serial 0x0. So first it will take the 2001 is nothing but the prefix, and the last bit it will generate from the link local address. That's the thing you are able to see, right? 2001. And the last is nothing but the 64-bit interface ID. So first always the prefix portion, and this last always will be the interface ID. So this interface ID is generated from the hardware address, that is a MAC address, 48-bit MAC address. Then it did the 48-bit MAC address, then it insert FFFE between the upper and the lower bytes, right? So that is the reason you are seeing here, this is a global unicast address, which is a routable address. So this is the one way of defining the global address. So another things you have to keep it in mind, I can assign multiple IPv6 address on a single interface. So let us go ahead and configure the second IPv6 address. So how we can do that? Go to interface serial 0x0 IPv6 address, any address you can give, 2001:111:// This is first is the prefix portion, and last I'm specifying like 2, then we have to do /128. This is a 128 bit address, right? So I have assigned this. Now we can check it out. Show IPv6 interface serial 0x0. So I can assign multiple IPv6 address on a single interface, right? So this is generated using EUI, and the second thing it is I assign directly this IPv6 address. This is the IPv6 address, right? So now let us see how to generate the IPv6 address on a host, that is a PC1. So what we can do, let us assign the IPv6 on this interface, right? Fast Ethernet 0x0, let us enable. And now I'm going to generate this host the IPv6 address, global address. How to assign the global address to PC, right? So how to do that? Go to R1 and go to the interface mode of Fast Ethernet 0x0 to which I have connected the host, right? So go here and let us assign the IPv6 address 2001:222, or we can give 33:1234:/64 EY64. So now what we'll do, automatically the host will generate its IPv6 global IPv6 address using this EY64, right? I'm going to show how to do that. So go to the PC, corresponding PC. So do a IP auto. So it will automatically assign using this address I have created. So now do show IPv6. So or else what we can do, just we'll remove this host, and I'm going to connect this host. I'm going to show how to do that. So go to this PCPS, I'm going to drag and drop. So now let us connect a link. Any link can give, let us give Fast Ethernet 0x1 or 0x0, and let us assign here And now let us enable the interface. Let us go to R1. So what we can do, let us interface fast Ethernet 0x0. So let us remove the address and let us assign it again. IPv6 address 2001.1234/64 EY64. So it will generate using EY64, right? So I already told about EY64. So now let us go to this PC. Let us do run it again. And now let us go to the PC. So go to the custom console and let us, I'm going to generate using FTP. So go here. So now there is no IP, right? No IPv6. So it will be having only, yeah, now it automatically got generated. After connecting this, it automatically got generated. Or I can do IP auto. So that will generate it using the, it will automatically generate the address from the R1, right? So now let us do show IPv6. So we're able to see, right, it is having the global link local, global address, unicast address that is generated using UI64. That is this is the thing I configured, right? Fast Ethernet 0. So we're able to see this is a global address. The first portion is a prefix portion, and the last one it is generated using the MAC address, right? It will take the 48-bit MAC address, then it will append to the prefix. That is the reason we are seeing 2050. So Y2 is nothing but the 7th bit, it always invert, right? So that's the reason we are seeing 2050. This is the last 64-bit we called as an interface IDs. So this interface ID generated from the 48-bit MAC address. It will take the 48-bit MAC address and it will append FFFE between the upper and the lower bits. And the 7th bit it will invert. That's the reason we are seeing here 2050/64. This first is the prefix and last is the interface ID. So this we called as a global unicast address. So this is the way we can generate the global unicast address on R1 and also the host. So global unicast address is a routable address which is routed through the internet and always start with 2001, right? So this is the way we can use global unicast address. I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me for more videos. Thank you and have a wonderful day.